boy, coming you can right
see
at
them. Golly, you see their backs coming out the water. This is one of the most incredible sights you'll ever see. These fish are coming out the water. They're right here. There's about 1,000 of them.
That's the way to do it now. That's the way to do it.
Oh, he's got one behind him. There he is. This is absolutely something that you see videos of and you don't believe them, but look at them. You can look at them in the waves. There's just tons of them.
Oh, a shark! A shark ate him! That's the way to do it now. That's the way to do it. Hey, is this South Louisiana fishing or what?
Closed captioning is brought to you by Cypress Cove Marine and Lodge in Venice, Louisiana, where you'll experience world-class fishing. Visit us online at cypresscovevenice.com. There's nothing like fishing in South Louisiana, especially on a day like today. When we're in Cocodrie, it is dead calm. We have this beautiful island, birds, clean water. You couldn't ask for better conditions. And we're with legendary Captain Stu Scheer, who's got a story to tell, a lot of fun to fish with, and we're gonna have a great time today on a gorgeous day in Cocodrie, Louisiana.
Oh, look here.
Got you another one, Stu?
Another good one, another good one.
Come on up. Good job, buddy. You're starting to put it on them now. Putting them on him.
That was decent fish.
Yeah, that's a nice one. Caught him on the top. Does it tell you anything when you're catching him on the top or on the bottom lure? Does it mean anything?
I don't think it does. You know, he just, that's the one he saw first and he grabbed it. Like 14, 15 incher.
So you're in year 46, right?
46, that's right. 46 years, and I don't know how many trips, Kevin, maybe 10,000, I don't know. Back when I was young, I used to fish 250, 275 days a year. Now I'm down to about 150, 180. But it's still a lot for an old man.
You're not that old.
Well.
I mean, you're not as old as the old man in the sea.
Getting close, though, huh?
I mean, you're getting there.
Yeah, this was about the size of 3 football fields last year. And look at it now, I mean, there's virtually nothing left. By the fall, by October, this will be gone. You might see a couple little tiny mounds, but they'll probably be gone completely.
You know, what people may not know, speaking of football, is you were a Mississippi State Bulldog, weren't you?
I was. I played for the Dogs back in the 60s, late 60s. Linebacker, tight end. Back, you know, I tell everybody, back when they had leather helmets, I think. But, I played against the Tigers 3 years.
How'd you do?
Lost 2-1-1 in the 3 years I was there.
Some things never change, huh?
Never change, that's right. Oh, look here, good fish on, good fish.
Boy, you guys are back in the boat of me. Look, I like this.
Good fish.
So how did you end up in Cocodrie? For people that don't know the story, how did you end up down here?
Well, I had a friend of mine when I was in junior high school, and his uncle had a camp down here. And we used to come down here and fish every chance we had, and just got to love it. When I got out of football, I came down here and set up a fishing and hunting operation and been here ever since.
Well, and these guys are on the back of the boat are killing them. Corey's
Stu's got one. Good
and,
fish, too.
And Kevin's just sitting here talking. All right, here, you
good
wanna?
Good fish.
Here.
Good double, here.
Oh, you
good
got a double? Oh, you had a double.
Lost one good one. Corey's got a good one.
Corey's got a good one. Hey, look what Kevin's got.
Kevin's got one on.
No, Kevin ain't got nothing on. That was a joke.
Oh, where he is.
There he is. Got him, Stu?
I missed him. Oh, he hit it again.
Got him. Good job, buddy.
Good fish. Good fish.
Real nice fish. Get him in, my brother. Is this your favorite month? What's your favorite month to fish out here?
Oh, I tell you, just whenever the weather's great, Kevin. As long as we got decent water and the winds are down, it's good any time from March till December, really. It's all about the conditions. You know, you've been down here with us a bunch of times, and it's all about the conditions and just being where the fish are.
Yeah. Nice fish, buddy. And these fish just feeding off this island.
Look here, fish on.
Look at this.
Fish on here.
Casting right on the side of it.
Good fish, good fish.
So, 46 years, you say you're getting as old as the old man in the sea.
I am the old man of the sea, the old man of Cocodrie for sure.
So why aren't you sitting in the rocket chair at home? What keeps you out here?
I'd be spreading mulch or pulling weeds, man. I can't do it. I got to be fishing.
It's just in your blood?
It's in my blood, man. I love it. Every day out here is beautiful. I just had another one hit it right there at the boat. I think I got a good double on now. I think I got a double.
I think you do, too.
I think you got
something big.
I felt him hit it. I felt that second one hit it.
What you got, buddy?
I got a good double.
Now this is what all about right there. Look at that double. Beautiful fish.
Look at here.
All right, let's see if you get him in. That's the fun. The fun part is already over.
Look at that.
Nice job.
How about it?
And thus right there.
That's why we use the double rig right there.
Is why you use the double
rig. That's 33 inches of fish right there. You can't beat it when they're smoking.
No, you can't.
Look at that. That's a good trout and Cocodrie right there. That's 18 inches.
And I want people to look at this bait. I'm going to talk about this when we cast out again. But you can buy these rigs ready-made. But when you buy them ready-made, the baits are not separated very far. Look how these are separated by about 18 inches or so. You can look at mine, you can look at his. You want to have them to where those baits are separated 18 inches or so, Stu, because those fish can, it's easier for those fish to hook the second bait it's like that. It's not impossible on the ready-made ones, but it's a hell of a lot harder.
Yeah, that's a big deal on them. We rig them ourselves because most of the commercial ones don't have enough gap.
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Dimco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
One of the things Kevin wanted me to explain to you is the importance of these double rig. You see the distance between the two baits, between the tail of this one and the head of this one, 18 to 20 inches minimum. You know, you want to be able to have a good gap. That's what we call a gap right there. A lot of times the commercial baits, they'll be real close together like this, and you're never going to catch a double like that because when you got one fish hooked, the other bait is so close to the fish that the second fish can't get on it. But when it's rigged like this with a wide range, if you got a fish here, you got that trailer way back here and the fish can get it. Same thing, if he gets this one first, you got this one trailing. So it's so important that you have that big gap. And without that, you're just not gonna be successful on doubles. And we always use, 30 pound test on the leader. I like to use a light 10 or 12 pound on the spinning reel because of the size of the reel I use. Whatever line you use doesn't really matter. Some people like to use the braided line. I personally don't. I'm strictly a monofilament guy. I think that the braid doesn't have the good balance that mono does, and I think it spooks them in clear water, but that's just my opinion. We're using a little 3/8 ounce head, and you want to make sure you tie it real good. And of course, we're using the all-famous motor oil avocado bait. So one I use 12 months a year, 7 days a week, and I've been using it nonstop since 83, and all the guys that work with me, we all use the same technique. And on a 12-month, 7-day-a-week basis, it's gonna win 80% of the time. Look here, look here. Look at them coming. Ooh, woo. Now that's what we call smoking now.
No. What you do now is bragging. I mean, I'm sitting on this side of the boat from you. I'm sitting right here. Now earlier when the fishing wasn't that good, We're not going to tell people what you were doing.
I know. I couldn't catch nothing.
You couldn't catch a fish. But now it's basically, it's not how you start, it's how you finish, huh?
Yep, that's it. But we slow it down a little bit, Kevin. Slow it down a little.
Okay. Yeah, I have a, oh, there, I see exactly what you're talking about.
Let's see, I got a big double on here again.
Well, I think I'm going to let you come on the other side. Yeah, I'm going to let you do something, because... And he's still nimble like a tight end, too. Oh, let me see. There we go. That's...
Yeah, big double, big
Yeah, look at
double.
This big double. I'm just getting out the way.
Look here. Look at this
I mean,
big
I'm
double.
Just getting out of the way.
That's 35 inches of fish right here. Look here. Look here. Up.
That's 18 inches off. Of fish.
Yeah, down to 18 inches now.
This man is, I'm casting with the same bait, the same everything, okay? Look at that pile of fish, okay?
I'm going to tell you like my grandpa used to tell me when I was a kid, you're not holding your mouth right.
I got look a big, here. Oh, look, oh, look I'm here. About to quit.
Look here.
This is a sin.
Look here.
Same bait. It's your damn bait I'm fishing with. All right, I'm going to throw out. And you're just letting it almost sink.
Yeah, working it real slow with little short little bumps. Short little bumps.
Oh, I missed it. Uh-oh.
Short little bumps. Look here.
I figured it
Look
out.
Look here. Kevin's
I figured
got a
it
good
out.
Fish. Kevin's got a good fish.
I figured it out.
He's got it down now. Look out.
Figured it out.
He's got
Look
it down.
That.
Oh, nice fish. Nice fish.
That's the way we're doing. And yes. We are having some fun over here. We need to get a bucket or something to put these fish away. They're getting all over us.
Don't, you know what we always say down here, Kevin? Don't worry about the mule, just load the wagon.
That's a good point. I'm gonna go put this in the wagon.
Oh, it's a nice trout, huh? Look at him.
Man.
Another good fish, another good fish. Oh.
Let me ask you a question. What is it about the avocado color that you like? Now look, I fish with a lot of colors all over the state. Very rarely am I fishing with avocado. That's all he brings on his boat. What is it about the avocado color?
I can't explain it. They just like it. They like it better than anything we've used. And we've been using it nonstop since 83.
Wow.
And it works. It really works good. I mean, you can catch fish on other colors. I mean, and other colors work, but on a 12-month, 7-day-a-week basis, nothing outfishes this one color. I'm telling you, nothing. Oh, look here. Fish on as soon as they hit the water. Oh, son.
Oh, yeah.
Am I under you?
No, yeah, you're under. You're good. I lost my bait and I'm trying to reel in with the left right hand. See, so I'm at a disadvantage now. Anything that I can use, Stu.
I got one going over the top.
You got one going over the top? I'm going to let you get over there. How about that? I'm going to let you get over.
All right. Oh, that's a nice one, too. That's a nice fish.
Very nice fish.
Look here. Oh. Big, beautiful trout. Big Cocodrie smoking. 16, 17 incher.
How did you end up in Cocodrie? I mean, I know we talked about liking the fish, but how did you end up here?
Well, when I was in the Saints camp for 2 years on the taxi squad, and my second year out, I got hurt. They put me on IR, and when I came off of that, they released me. You know, and I was kind of in a dark area there for a few months, and you know what? I said, I'm going to do the next best thing. I'm going to come down here and set up a fishing operation, fishing and hunting, and I did in 1971 and been here ever since. There he is, look here.
I'm just having fun watching you.
I'm trying to get that second one on there now. I'm not trying to add insult to injury.
But tell us how you get the second one on there, what you do.
You just kind of keep a tight line, Kevin. Don't work the fish in real close. Just let that other bait work, let the fish work. When they're in a frenzy, that second one's gonna pick it up. a lot of people have a tendency to, when they hook a fish, they want to reel him in quick. Watch here, look here.
That's two of them, huh?
Yeah, two good fish.
Thank you. Two real, ooh, yes,
look
sir.
Look at that, look at that.
But if you just take your time.
Just take your time.
That second fish has got a really good chance of getting on there.
That's right, when they're in a big school like that, that second fish is gonna hit it. They can't stand it when one of them has it and the other one doesn't.
We got a pile of fish on this boat and it hasn't taken long and I still can't catch one. Oh, there we go.
Look here.
Oh, mine's on top of the water already.
Yeah, don't reel so fast.
I'm not gonna, he's jumping out. Look at that.
Keep your tip down low, get that second one.
I have my tip down low now. I know I've got a fish on here already.
Don't work him fast.
I'm not working him fast. I haven't got that second one because you'll feel the second one just like you will the first one. And I don't, but look at this. I'll take this one. How about that? Right on this island. We're probably about 10 minutes from the marina. And check these out, folks. These are some nice, nice speckled trout. Come get you some. Double rigs, avocado. He's been doing this same exact bait since 1971. This is all the guy fishes with. It's it, unless he goes and fishes in the marsh for redfish. This is it. There's mine.
There he is. Look here, Kevin's on him now, baby. Kevin's got the technique down.
I haven't got the double technique down yet, but I've got the single. It's so pretty to come out here and sit out these islands and just throw out and catch speckled trout after speckled trout. I got my catcher's mitt. I just got my catcher's mitt, so you're wondering why I haven't used it some. I forgot I had it on me. But check this out. Great glove. Takes the fish off. I have pliers on here as well that can cut braid pretty good. And my net and my glove's not going to go anywhere because it's attached. Lands on this so it doesn't get your pants dirty. You got a little towel on the back of it. And check out the pliers. The pliers are pretty good. Look at these pliers. I mean, these are really, really good pliers, and they will cut braid. All right here on your waist. Just put it back on the holster and go fish.
Fish on here.
You got it?
Fish on here, Kevin.
Good job, bud.
Trying to get that double, not working him too fast. Trying to keep that line tight, keep that rod tip low.
We're only in, what, about 2-3 feet of water?
Yeah, about 4 foot. Solid shell. That was an easy release.
And it's that shell that...
Yeah, I think they use that shell in here. And wherever you have a shell bank, I think they use it for spawning purposes. I'm not sure exactly why. But we always do good anywhere where there's
there
a big shell base. Fish on here, fish on.
I like when you say fish on like that.
That's right, Kevin's got it down now. Here you go,
pretty. No, I don't get it. I'm only catching singles though. You catch all those doubles, brother. Yeah. You catching the doubles. But it's pretty to come out here and fish by these islands. And you got the birds. And you know, if you're from out of state and you're watching the show and you might necessarily not want to just come fishing, we have some excellent birding down here too. I mean, you can come down here and get on some of these islands and the birding is just absolutely incredible. It really is. So something a little bit different you can do down here when you're in Cocodrie. You got a single or a double?
Single right now, but I'm trying to get that double. Keep that bait in the water. Keep it in the water. Keep your line tight, but don't force it. See how I'm just keeping it tight? I only reel when the pole slacks up a little bit. Let that other bait work as much as you possibly can. Much as you can. Doesn't mean you're always going to get a double, but it gives you a shot at a double. Okay. Oh, man.
That's a pretty good single.
Does it get any better, Kevin?
No. No, it doesn't.
Doesn't get any better.
Fish on.
Good fish.
All right. Well, this has been a clinic put on at this last spot by Captain Stu Scheer. And come on down here. Captain Stu's got everything you need. They launch out of Sportsman's Paradise.
great marina with good overnight accommodations, super restaurant as well. We've got a lot of great things. Captain Corey in the back of the boat's got a fish. Captain Stu Scheer has got at least one, maybe two fish on his line right now. And this is what it's all about, coming down here this time of year in double rigging in Cocodrie, Louisiana. A double right there to end the day. And Captain Stu, hey man, thanks for a great day.
Oh man, look here, big double. Oh, got that double coming in. How about it?
Thank you, my friend, for a great day. I want to thank Captain Corey for helping us out here today as well. Give Captain Stu Scheer a call. Come on out here and go fishing and listen to the stories. This guy's been doing it as long as anybody in Louisiana, and he's probably caught more speckled trout than anybody in Louisiana. You'll catch fish and have a great time listening to the stories too. Hey, thanks for watching this week, and we'll hope to see you again next time right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.